Kaiser Wish the Great, if you will stay in this in Krakow, or if you will go to any other our trips, you will hear this name a lot. Kaiser Wish the Great is not the Polish king, which was the great one, and one of the reasons is exactly a Jagiellonian university. He started it in Hamburg in 1364. But interesting thing, when the university started work here, it wouldn't have the most important faculty. Can you guess the most important faculty in medieval ages? Theology. Medicine is important, philosophy is important, but theology, learning about God, is the most important. And actually, there was no theology in the beginning. In the 15th century, our kings start to write to the Pope, try to make, possibility to make a theology here. They succeeded. Kings who succeeded were actually coming from Jagiellonian dynasty, so you have Jagiellonian University. And also there's a legend, a queen, a wife of the man called Jagiełło, who established Jagiellonian dynasty. Legend said that Jadwiga died as a poor woman. In her last will, on her dying bed, she left all the treasures, all the jewels, and all the clothes that she had to Jagiellonian University. And then 15th, 16th century university is growing, getting into the line of most known universities in Europe. And many famous people were studying here. We'll talk later about two of them. Nicolaus Copernicus, the astronomer, man who moved the sun, stopped this, and moved the earth. And the second, John Paul II, Karol Wojtyła, also we'll talk about him. There are no classes held in Collegium Maius here. This is a museum. If you'd like to know more about the history of the university, very good place. But not go further, you will see faculties of Polish, archaeology, history, Jagiellonian University.